And that's pretty much our whole stay, but this is Jeju-do Island. As you can see, it's formed by a large volcano, a series of volcanic eruptions. There's several volcanoes, but that's the main one. That's the culprit right there. It's a really neat island. It's not that, it looks big, but it's really not. I mean, it doesn't take that long to drive around it. Oh well, we better go. We gotta catch a taxi back today. They tried to rip us off today. Didn't they, honey? Oh, we wouldn't let them rip them off.
They did math calculations right in front of them.
Yeah, we showed him how what our figures were and what his figures
were.
And
we just sat in there until he gave us our money.
Then he reluctantly gave up 3,000 more won. And Tammy was happy. So was I.
Happy. I was pretty mad that he wasn't going to. But he was going to.
We memorized his taxi number though, didn't we?
We wrote it down.
Tammy wrote down his license number and I wrote down his driver's license and Tammy wrote down his license tag. So we got him. We're gonna get him. Alright, so long. Say bye.
Bye.
This is Tammy's idea of a good time.
We're having fun.
What are you
doing? We're on a bus ride and we didn't know where we were going. We just hopped on the bus to see where it took us so we could make sure that we got to the airport on time on Sunday. So we decided to go to a cave, see some caves, because that's on the way.
And the weather's bad.
Yeah, the weather's terrible. It's raining all day.
You can see the wetness on the window and the dirty clouds. Here we are on the bus. Jeju Island.
I said Z instead of Ne, but yes.
Si, senor. Si, senor. No comprende. Alright, so long. Hi, hon.
Hi.
We're at Holland Park. Rode the bus.
It's pretty. It was only 2,000 won.
Pretty cheap ride, huh?
Huh?
Pretty cheap ride.
Pretty cheap, since we paid 7,000 to go not near as far yesterday.
Well, excuse me. Can you push the button for me?
Oh, sure. Sure. Okay.
First time you're taking a picture of some natives. Trying to push the button for him. Tell him to say kimchi.
Yeah, just push.
Okay. Say kimchi.
Okay. Thank you.
Hey.
You're
hey. Not a very good tour guide.
Hi.
Hi,
we're
welcome.
We're gonna go see the caves at Holland Park.
We're going caving.
We went to the bonsai, see a bonsai garden. It was very beautiful.
Lovely.
And now there's sand. This is the first sand we've seen.
Real live sand that they should have on their beaches.
But
instead they have these rocks on their beaches and this sand on their walkways. Go figure. But anyways, here we are.
There's a bamboo fence.
At the Highland Park bamboo fence cave site. And this is the long walk we're going down to see the entrance of the cave. Supposedly 19 caves, but I don't think we're going to go through all of them.
Of course we are.
I don't think we'll have the opportunity to go through all. I'll go through every one of them if I have the opportunity. Annyeonghaseyo! Yeah, just an experiment, see if they'd answer. Oh well. I don't know where the entrance of the cave is, so I guess it's time to go.
Goodbye.
Until later. Until then, so long.
Fire this way.
What are you, yeller?
Not yeller.
Hey.
Come on, come in this pit.
Tammy doesn't think this is the way into the cave, but I'm pretty sure this is the way.
It's like a maintenance building.
I think this is a cave.
Ooh, look. Ew, don't fall.
Why don't you not fall?
It's like pure mud.
It's dripping pure mud right on top of us, too.
This is one neat cave.
Kind of Indiana Jones-ish.
Oh, it smells good in here.
Tammy loves the smell of what? Fungi?
Mildew.
Mildew.
Everybody loves the smell of mildew.
Come on, let's go. I'm scared.
Yeller? What if we get trapped in here?
What if we're going the wrong way? We're supposed to have a tour guide with us.
What if we get trapped in here?
Cool.
We've had mud all over our body.
I gotta go. There's people selling stuff. So long, bye. I mean, I have to go back the other way because we followed her through that cave and it was the wrong way.
No, you went the wrong way. I said we had to go the other way and you said no.
Oh, now you have to bust me out and make me look like I'm the guy that led us the wrong way. I was trying to be nice and not blame it on anybody.
You lied is what you did.
I didn't lie. I said I was following you and it was the wrong way.
I said I was the one that went the wrong way.
Whatever. Well, anyways. We're going backwards through the caves and all the lights were shining in our face instead of...
And it's very dark and scary.
We couldn't see anything because the lights were in our eyes and they weren't on the rocks. Everybody thought we were idiots.
All the way around.
So I have to go all the way around to go through the very beginning of all the caves. All right. So long. I'd like to see them put their feathers up for us. Look at that one's blue neck. Look at that neck on that thing. So good. We caught that one pretty easily. You missed all the excitement though.
Oh, he's done.
He's doing a good job now. Oh man.
This one here was
the first time he got hit in the face about twice, three times. It was very funny. So funny. He's too slow. He doesn't have his heart, whole heart in this game. Get away, get away. Escape.
Yeah.
This is funny. Phew, it really stinks here. Oh, we got one.
Here we go, left him.
He's got you, little guy.
He thinks he's
in it too now, doesn't he? He's feeling kind of cocky now. Get him. Escape. Ooh, he's quicker. The hand is quicker than the eye, folks.
Aww.
I wonder if they're going to eat those things.
Probably. Shove them in bags.
Oh, well. Fun's over. Watch this. Oh, I don't think so. There's the old grandfather, they call him, the grandfather statue. It's famous here on Jeju-do.
Is it really? That's the big one?
It's not the grand. No, it's just some. They're all. There's no one statue, honey.
Okay.
All right, bye. Are we live?
Wait. There.
Oh, we're fading?
Okay.
Are we fading?
We're on
live now? We got the willies right now, Tammy and I. Because I'm standing amongst thousands of living creatures right now, little bitty, leech-like, clammy bugs. Show them, Tammy.
It's really repulsive.
See all these little white things? They're like clams or bugs or
leeches or something.
All these little white things are alive.
They're really alive. If you don't believe me, I'm gonna prove it right now. Let's find a good one, honey. Come on. Oh, here's one right here.
Wait.
It looks kind of dead. It's kind of wet, but let's show you.
Which one? Wait, let me get one. Okay.
I don't want to get too close. I don't want to be able to jump really high because it freaks out.
All right, I'm ready.
Shoot some poisonous gelatin at it. Are you ready?
Uh-huh.
This is 101.
Wait, I don't think I got the right one.
This one right here? Or this one? This one will hold it. He'll actually hold on to the coin, I think. Are you ready?
All right. Wait, move your umbrella.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you ready? Are you zoomed in good?
I'm ready.
Is it focused on my fingers?
Yes. Ooh, get that quarterback.
He's sucking on it. Look at him.
Grab it! Ew!
Dude, he closed in on it good.
Do the ones that move fast.
They'll move fast. It's gross. They're all over this whole rock, all these rocks.
They are alive.
They're all alive.
I have never seen anything so disgusting.
Look
at all these. All these.
Maybe they're just
spots.
Like barnacles or something. Maybe that's what they are.
But they move.
Well, barnacles move. They suck onto the ships and stuff. I don't know what they are,
they're
but it's
standing
sick.
Amidst.
You've seen that movie, The Puppet Masters. You'd have the creepy colors like that same idea.
We saw a really scary movie. That water's pretty, isn't it?
It's in their barnacles. Look at this one.
Ew.
Did you see it?
A little.
Is that sick or what?
There's lots of living creatures.
Is that a good one? On film?
Yeah. Do one from the side and see it
squiggle
away.
What if they went, wouldn't that be gross? They went, that'd be sick. You touched the coin. What do you want to do now? Let's get a stick and poke them.
This is our white beach.
Let's get a stick and poke them.
Beautiful. We need a stick so we can poke them a little.
Let's get out of here before they start sucking under my shoes and we can't leave. We have to take off all our clothes just to get out of here because they're attached to all of us. Shall we go?
All right.
Ooh, there's one on your shoe. That cold, honey.
Yes, it is. And this water is freezing cold. There's nothing warm about it. Sit the door if you don't mind, pervert.
I'm a pervert.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Put it away.
He's so shy.
You better put it away. I'm not going to run around naked on video.
Why not?
Put it away so I can get dressed. It's cold over here.
Okay, hurry up.
Put it away. Are you going to be in trouble?
Here we are back at Holland Park, and on the beach again. We went and decided to come back. It's our last day in Jeju-do Island. And Brian's thinking he's tough. Pretty,
it's
what?
The expectorate.
Expectorate? Yeah. got it all on film. You look like a monster.
Thank you very much.
From this angle.
Cold water's freezing cold.
It's cold out here. I can't even think of going in the water. I didn't think he'd go very far. He's pretending he is. Strong and wimp! Wimp!
No way!
Says it's too cold, no way. He's gonna be a sissy. He's going in though.
We can fix it later. No, it ain't. You're looking good. I think you look good. You don't look cold.
You look hot.
Stop! Stop!
I've been out there again.
Stop, no.
Come on, one more time. Come on, baby.
I've
been out there for.
No, I don't want footage.
I do.
I don't want it though.
You chicken. Been out there for the fans.
Maybe later.
For the viewers at home.
Maybe later.
For the TV audience.
Let me warm up a little bit.
Alright, I'll warm the TV audience up a little bit.
Turn it off.
Why should I?
They're just trying to drown this crab. Not trying to drown him, we just want him to come out again. He's green and very cute.
Here they come.
What should we name him?
Huh?
What should we name him?
I don't know. Krusty?
He's not very crusty.
Yeah, he's quicker. Only how I can see.
He's quicker than my other crabs I have, isn't he?
Mm-hmm. He's playing with the sand in there. He's spitting it around, blowing air bubbles.
He's not focusing. We poured water in his shell so he came out.
Is it focused?
Mm-hmm. He moved it back a little.
Come on, Christy.
Come on, little Christy. Coming out.
He's boring me. I'm drowning him.
I'm drowning him. Christy. Christy, it was your own fault. You should have come out and played with us.
Come out still.
Say something.
Huh?
Say something.
Here he comes.
Don't say too much.
I think the tone. I think he likes the tone, the smooth tones. Here he comes. You see him?
So good.
Because you keep moving, silly.
There. My hair's in the way.
His shell's full of water. He needs to come out of there so he can breathe.
Come on out, Krusty.
Come on out of there, Krusty. So we can eat you.
We're going to have you for dinner. How could we eat our good friend, Krusty?
I wouldn't dare eat my good friend, Krusty. Krusty the crab.
You scared him. Look what you're doing.
I don't care about scaring the crab.
Here he comes, because he can't take it in.
He can't breathe much longer underneath the water.
That's too loud. Hey, chicken. Krusty's taking too much time.
TV audience is getting bored. Pause. For station identification.
I think we're gonna have to.
Now for the exciting conclusion.
Of Krusty the Crab.
Of Krusty the Crab emerges from his shell. I think he scared something. I don't know. He has like nightmares or something. He just jerks back in there.
He's remembering a minute ago when he threw water in him. There's a bunch of boys along the beach taking pictures of each other.
I think they're all. Never mind.
They get much closer to each other here than we do in America. Much more touchy-feely.
Korea is a much more touchy-feely nation.
Whereas we need our space bubbles. Some lady was caressing Brian's leg yesterday. Because it was so big. She had never seen a lake that big. Oh. I'm getting bored. See, these are the people. Everyone just comes and takes pictures, pictures, pictures. Krusty?
I see his eyes. He sees me. Never mind, he went back in.
Krusty.
Problem. He's being a brat today. I'm gonna punish him by throwing him against the wall.
He would never. Alright, I guess I'll bait out.
Well, we'll come back for the exciting conclusion a little bit later.
Yeah. Darn you.
Alright, cut it, you little jerk.
Here comes Krusty, he's a little crab. He's tired of being drowned by us.
Why do you want to take a parent picture of your foot?
I was going to, but I decided not to.
You're kind of funny. It'd
be quite a panorama. Come on, Krusty, push.
You can do it, Krusty.
Push. 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 Come on, push.
Come
a little
on,
bit
Krusty.
More. A little bit more, Kruster.
He twitches. He keeps flipping back in.
These things scare him. He might sense his vibrations that we don't. He is as green as a big old piece of pickle. He wants to flip his shell back over.
And then he'll just sit there and do nothing, like boring old crab.
He's like a toddler.
He's an acrobat.
I was hoping he's gonna fall back over the other way. Where's he going, to the shade?
Rusty. Come back. I told you they like the shade. She's in little feelers. She's gonna sit there.
Not if I have anything to say about it.
Don't
it's cruel, Brian. It's cruel, Brian. Right back where you came from. And here's a little something to drink while you're at it, too, buddy.
Don't.
I won't.
He's tired.
Thought maybe he's coming back out again.
There he is. He's like, look. Look at that foot.
I thought it would make an interesting panoramic photo.
Maybe it would.
You ever seen those Magic Johnson?
No, I don't.
Tell me about it.
No.
What'd you say?
I was just going to say you can make them those, you know how they have those Magic Johnson and Larry Bird wall growth charts? They're life size and they're about 6'9".
Uh-huh.
And I thought I could have like a growth chart for people's feet.
Oh, that'd be neat.
Take a panoramic photo, make it life size, and then kids could chart their growth progress on their feet. Maybe that wasn't such a good idea.
Krusty
witnessed a crime, and now he's a federal witness. So he's given a whole new identity, and we're going to relocate him. That's like the witness relocation program.
It's for his own good.
For his own safety. Because there's the birds out here that want to kill him.
There's a lot of things that would want to kill Krusty.
For what he's seen, for what he knows. So he's being relocated and given a completely new identity. He used to have a different name, which we can't tell you, but now his name is Krusty.
Krusty the Crab.
We're trying to find him a good home.
Right here by this little side water.
This mossy stuff.
I like this side. There's lots to eat on that moss, though. Hey, Ryan.
I think half in the water, half out is a good start for him. How about you?
Yeah, I think so. So that way, if he wants to go in the water, he can. I don't think they like water that much. All right?
I think just needed is a little bit of water, though. I bet that's a little bit colder than what we were pouring on him. Okay, Krusty. Good luck.
Alright.
Godspeed. You're pretty cool. Multiply. Look at that. He has his very own litter right there to hide underneath. It's a perfect place for him, I think.
Alright, let's go. I'm being stared at.
Come on, Kruster.
You ready?
Oh, you can quit if
you want.
Are
you ready to say goodbye?
No, I want to make sure he likes his new home.
Alright.
You gonna go? How do you feel uncomfortable, honey? Come on, Crestola.
Oh, he's feeling good. I think he's real happy about his new location. He's a long way from where his old place was, which is way
over there somewhere. I think, there it is, over here. He's from over in that area, that neighborhood. We moved him all the way over to here.
All right, dear. Okay, I'm coming. One out, Krusty. Oh well. I'm sure he'll be all right. So long from Jeju Island, South Korea, home of Krusty the Krab.
Ryan just got done doing manual labor, working with the people. He had to move a whole bag of grain so we could pass this lady's little, what do you call it, cart?
She had it blocking the road.
So he had to lift the bag of grain because she started yelling at him.
She was nice, though.
She was really sweet, and then they laughed. And then they let him pass after he moved a bag of grain. And we're coming out here tonight to watch the sunset.
Here, sit down now.
It's beautiful.
I'll hold this.
Okay. Up there is where we just came from. I hope we can find our way back.
We will be fine. Honest, we will. It's true. I have eyes like a cat. I can see through the dark.
I don't know.
Look at
she
that
got sunburned
ice cold.
Pretty bad.
Look at the ice cold Pacific Ocean. Yeah, we were waiting in a different part of the island today. We went waiting and sunbathing, and we got totally cooked. Bright
in weird
red.
Ways. Brian got really dark though. He always looks.
I'm green. Red though. I don't know if you can see camera how well the color can see that. I mean, like.
You're
camera.
Red.
I'm red right
Your
here because I put lotion here. Okay.
Have a look.
I'm really raw. I'm red right here, really bad. I'm hurting. It's kind of sore.
And your face is a little red.
Can you focus on me?
Mm-hmm.
My face is really red.
My legs are red.
Look at this. I'm going to show them the difference in your two-tone leg. Well, they probably see when you get home. Look at that on her leg. It's bad. It probably
Silly.
Hurts too.
Because Brian rubbed lotion on me.
And her face is cooked good.
I think that's it.
Well, we were hoping for a sunset, but it looks like the clouds came in at the last minute and took away our... It was sunny all day, as you can tell from our skin, but I guess that cloud moved in and ruined our sunset. But maybe it'll turn pink towards as it gets a little lower. So if it does, we'll turn it back on again. If not, we'll see you later. So long, everybody.
Okay. Yeah.
These are all fishing ships out at sea. Way out there, all along the horizon. So many ships out there trying to catch a fish. It's really neat. 8 o'clock. Yeah, about 8 o'clock at night. Sun's down. Starting to get dark, and so they turn their lights on to track the fish. It's really pretty out here.
Oh, excuse me.
Hello, welcome to the show. Hi, sweetie. Hello, everybody. Still here, huh? Still watching the movie, are you? I decided to go ahead and make a tape while I shine my combat boots. So that way, in case whatever I'm saying is boring, at least you get to see how we do it here in the Army. It's pretty neat. First, you gotta dust off all the dust. All the dirt and crud. Knock it off. You start applying your shoe polish. It's quite a simple process. I really don't do this every day, so I don't think I'm a real hard-working soldier. Usually, I just take this at the end of the beginning of the morning and just brush on, because usually I have leftover kiwi on here. So, how's everybody doing? Hope you enjoyed the movie. Hello, how are you, honey? Tammy. I just talked to you a little while ago. On the phone. It's a bit about the car. Wish we'd have got it. But it's okay. I'm sure it'll all work out. I'm not worried about it. But then I'll stop beating by one of those bikes at an auction and we'll be alright, won't we? I ain't riding no bike next year. I'll have to find us a car somehow. Maybe you can ride a bike. I guess you've discovered the secret to the Army spit shine. It's not really spit, it's water. I have it down there in a can. Actually, usually I do spit, but I don't want to gross you out. Because then I don't like that. Thoughtful, aren't I? So considerate. Well, dear, oh, this is as exciting as you expected. Actually, just a little extra bonus for you. The main thing will be the movie before that we made. As you can hear, I still got stipples. Excuse me. Hopefully get rid of them soon. I've been having them forever, since a week after you left, or before you left. It sucks. I don't like it. You're getting tired of it. Sunday night right now. Sunday evening. 7:15 to 8. Mostly about this time of night, all the guys are starting to wrap up their weekend activities here in the barracks, and things will start getting a little more active around here. All people start slamming doors and coming in and asking questions. Hey, what's Tom's formation and everything? So, I'm sure I won't have too much more peace and quiet anymore. Scott's on CQ right now. He's got it all night. He won't get off till tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. He's just down the hallway. He might come in every now and then. Maybe he'll stop in and say hi to us. Then again, maybe not. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Like my haircut? I got it really short. Super short. For the summer. For the field, really. It's supposed to be getting pretty hot soon. But I don't want to have that big long bob I had earlier. It's kind of a real short, nice, easy, carefree haircut. I might be getting one too soon, huh? And then you want to cut all your hair off. It's okay if you do. I like it long too, though. I like it both ways. Actually, I don't know if I like it short. I've never seen you short hair, but
sure I'll like it.
I'm sure it'll be cute however you do it.
I hate when I pull it all the time, so maybe it will be better if it's short, if you want to do it that way. I wouldn't worry about it. You can always grow out of it too, you're still a youngster. I'm with about 25 now. You got a lot of years left in your hair. In fact, if you're gonna cut it short, you might as well do it now. Because later on you might not be able to grow it back longer if you don't like it, if you wait till later. If I were you, well, I'd do whatever you want. Don't make a decision based on what I want. Because I cut out mine off, as you can see. Didn't ask you. I think you're beautiful no matter what, anyways. Made a tape like this before where it's all boring. I'm off working in my on something besides just talking to you. It's kind of different, kind of strange. But it's a lot more boring. Oh well. Maybe it's a lot more like talking to me, except for I don't listen anymore. Especially not now. All I do is talk, and you just have to listen. You can't even talk back to me. Unless I make it kind of like I'm listening. I'll try it. Did you just have something you want to say, honey? Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, go ahead. Go ahead, tell me. Yeah, I know, it's alright, honey. Don't worry about that. Oh, really? Okay. Oh, man. Ooh. Huh? There, maybe now you can rewind that and use an army whenever you want to. That way, hold on, I'll make some more realistic ones too. I'll make ones where I'm not listening to you. When you can still be talking to me, and I'll just be sitting here. Then I'll ask you to say it all over again. Or you could ask me, you know, and I'll just go, huh? Just like old times, you know. That way, whenever you have something you want to tell me, you can just tell the tape. And it'll just get you, that way you can get things off your chest. Is that a good idea? Maybe not. You don't have to answer that if you don't want to. By the time you get this, I hope you already sent my book and my all those pictures you're going to send me from the trip. You better have. Boots just start shining up like I hoped they would. I'm kind of disappointed. True spit shine. It gives it extra high gloss. Yeah, they're just kind of not so hot looking today. Oh well. They'll do. One down, one to go. Honey, I don't know much else to say. I suppose you want me to keep it all anyway, though, because you like to look at me. I don't know if you do or not, but... really, I don't know what else to say, so I guess I'll just let this... I'm going to stop this thing, because then I'm going to record it on the big tape while I'm shining my other boot. Then I'll watch it and make sure it's not too stupid. Right. Oh, wait, I think Scott's coming. No, but it's just somebody else. Oh, well. I love you. And miss you, and hopefully you'll call me when you get this before I go to the field. Hopefully, you should get by the end of the week.